Hi everyone, welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another basic derivative problem today. This one is y equals x to the 6th minus 7x to the 4th plus 5 over x. So the first thing we need to do, we'll have no problem with the first two terms, but the third term, where we have a fraction here and an x in the denominator, will give us some trouble if we don't convert this to something that's not a fraction. So what we'll go ahead and do is focus on this third term and first convert it to something that'll be more simple for us to derive. And the way that we're going to do that is by moving x to the numerator. So currently, x is raised to the power of 1, right? It's x to the 1 as opposed to x squared or something. We don't write it because it's implied, but it's actually x to the 1. And if we move that to the numerator, all we have to do is change the sign on the 1 from a positive to a negative, and that will allow us to bring it up to the top. So if we just convert that fraction, we'll get x to the 6th minus 7x to the 4th plus 5, and then we say to the times x to the negative 1. And see, I just added that negative sign, and that allowed us to bring this whole term into the numerator. These terms, 5x to the negative 1 and 5 over x to the 1, are the same thing. So we just converted it, and this will be something now that we can easily take the derivative of. So when we take the derivative, we'll call it y prime. And again, remember, when we're taking basic derivatives, all three of these terms will simply use the power rule, where we multiply the exponent by the coefficient and then simply subtract 1 from the exponent. So we'll bring 6 out in front here, and we'll have 6x to the 6 minus 1 minus 7 times 4. We bring, again, that exponent out into the front, times x to the 4 minus 1. So again, bringing the exponent out in front and then subtracting 1 from the exponent each time. And then plus 5 times negative 1, bringing the negative 1 out in front here, times x to the negative 1 minus 1. And that is essentially the power rule. So now we've taken the derivative, and all we have to do is simplify. So when we simplify, we'll get y prime equals 6x to the 5 minus 28x to the 3. And then this 5 minus, or times negative 1 is going to be a negative 5. So we'll just have minus 5 x to the negative 2. And we could leave our answer here, but it would be much cleaner if we convert this term back into a fraction so that we don't have this negative exponent here, which is kind of nasty. And the way that we do that is by, just like we moved the x into the numerator by changing the sign on the exponent, we can move it back into the denominator by, again, flipping the sign on the exponent. So we'll end up, as our final answer, with y prime equals 6x to the 5th minus 28x to the 3rd, and then we'll have minus 5 over x squared. And notice that all we did was change the sign on the exponent from a negative to a positive. So now instead of x to the negative 2, we have x squared, and that's now in the denominator of the fraction. And this is a much cleaner answer, which ends up being our final answer. Thanks! See you guys next time!